Hi, it's Nick from the Run Testers, and this is our review of the New Balance Fuel Cell Rebel V2. Kick off with a few of the key stats on the shoe. Let's start with the weight, because this is a really light shoe. My UK size 9 weighs 204 grams, which is 7 ounces, kind of on the nose. I've weighed it a few times. It kind of hovered between kind of 200 grams and 204 grams. Whichever of those it is, that's a very light shoe for considering how much foam it's got here. It costs £120 in the UK or $130 in the US, and it has a 6mm drop from heel to toe. When it comes to design, you've got this lovely juicy stack of New Balance's fuel cell foam here. Fuel cell is New Balance's kind of, I think, highest performance foam, it's fair to say. They tweak the formulation in different shoes. This has got quite a soft blend, especially to the touch. It feels something like akin to maybe the TC or the RC Elite, those kind of high performance shoes. And yeah, like I say, there's a really big stack of it on the shoe. What there isn't is a carbon plate. This is a plate-free shoe. I know, 2021, craziness. That does mean, at some points, I think the foam has lacked a little bit of direction and stability, but it's not an unstable shoe, I will say that. But yeah, it doesn't have a carbon plate in there, which is like the key difference to things like New Balance's TC and RC Elite shoes. The upper on the previous version of the shoe was a kind of booty. This is now kind of a mesh with a separate tongue. And it's got this kind of offset lace design, this lovely black line that comes into the middle there. And then it's got a decent amount of padding around the heel here, I have to say. For a shoe that weighs 200 grams, this is, you know, really quite plush around the cushion here. There's a good amount of cush here, which does kind of point to the fact that this is a shoe that's not just built for speed, despite its, you know, its lack of weight. It's something that you can use for lots of training. On the first edition of the shoe, there was a really big flange that stuck out from the side here. That's kind of gone. It was an odd feature of the shoe. I guess added a little bit of a kind of stability, lateral stability, but clearly New Balance didn't feel it was really needed. It's not made it to the second version of the shoe. But to compensate, they've given us this really cool little magic eye thing that changes from New Balance to fuel cell depending on which way you tilt the shoe. So that's quite nice. The outsole is kind of a mix of rubbers. The kind of black sections here are harder wearing, so kind of key impact zones for heel strikers like myself here, or maybe around for your toe off at the front there. But yeah, they look quite durable to me. They've come up and they've actually done a decent job of gripping in a good range of conditions for me during my run testing. So yeah, within New Balance's range, this obviously comes in as a carbon plate free, fast trainer, versatile trainer, as opposed to things like the TC, which are much more expensive. If you don't want a carbon plate, but you still want to enjoy the kind of speed side of New Balance's fuel cell foam, this is the best shoe within the range to get, I would say. So when it comes to the fit of the shoe, the first thing to say is this is a short shoe. Going true to size, it does come up very short in the toe box. In my first run, I ended up with some bleeding around my toes. That was mostly my fault. I hadn't cut my toenails. But at the same time, it does come up short. You might want to go half a size up, I think, to have a slightly roomier fit there. Since then, I haven't had any problems with the fit as it is. I don't mind the fit of the shoe too much, but there's definitely scope to go half a size up. Around the rest of the shoe, in the midfoot and the heel, you get a nice, solid lockdown fit. No problems on any of those fronts. So I've done a 75k of running in the Rebel 2, and it's a shoe I'm still not 100% sure where I stand on. It really threw me from the start, you know. Coming into the Rebel shoe with this big stack of, you know, nice springy foam, this very lightweight thing, I really had it pegged as a really speedy shoe. And it didn't really convince me on that front from the start. Like on the first run I did, it's quite a fairly long run, 90 minutes, easy to steady. And actually it felt better at the easy paces. And I've actually kind of had that experience throughout training with it. It's much more versatile than I thought it was going to be. I will say that straight from the off. This is a lightweight shoe, but there's enough support and cushioning there for a lot of daily training. And that's really impressive, I think, for such a light shoe. It's comfortable, it's nimble, it's lightweight, and it is still versatile enough to handle speed sessions. I've done kind of two fast, hard runs in this shoe now. I think I've done a track session in it where I also used the Puma Deviate Nitro to compare this to a shoe with a carbon plate across a couple of sets of 2K at 315 pace and then 5 400 meter reps. And then the other hard run I did in the shoe was a kind of a alternating 10K at 1040 and 320 pace. So on the track session, it was noticeable when I switched to the Deviate Nitro, you do get a lot more kind of forward propulsion from the shoe with the carbon plate. And also the foam, I think, in Puma's range, that kind of nitrogen-infused EVA does have a little bit more kind of stability and kind of forward energy return than the shoe. I think when I really stepped up the pace to 400 meter pace, I just feel like there's a lot of foam here. Your foot bottoms out a little bit. You get lost in that foam a little bit. You don't necessarily get the drive through the shoe and off in a kind of direct forward motion, as opposed to losing a little bit in the kind of slight sloppiness of this foam. However, taking it down the pace to kind of those 2K reps or the 10K, I was actually really quite impressed with how it performed at speed. Just the fact it's so light does help. It's very nimble. Fuel cell foam is really good. I do like it. I think I still prefer it with in combination with the plate on something like the New Balance Fuel Cell TC. But there's no doubt that the Rebel has got plenty of pace in it. And I did roll through that 10K quite comfortably at the end of a reasonably hard week of training, and thought really quite impressed. I actually wasn't meant to use the shoe for that session, but I'd had some kind of heel problems with another shoe, so I switched to the Rebel at the last minute. Wasn't really too sure I wanted to use it because I hadn't found it exceptional at faster runs. But then, yeah, it did win me over a fair bit during that 10K. And then I've taken it out for really slow recovery plods as well, not even just kind of easy runs. And again, it's been surprisingly good. And one of those was even in the woods on fairly rutted tracks, and I didn't find this shoe unstable at all on that. So there are a lot of points in the plus column with this shoe, I have to say, which is why it's thrown me a fair bit, because I still don't really feel like I'm in love with it. I've just had a lot of good runs in it, but it still doesn't have a ride that I truly can say I enjoy in the same way as a few other shoes, which we'll discuss kind of in the verdicts and alternatives section. The one other thing I will say is, over longer runs, so when I have gone kind of past 75 minutes, you know, kind of an hour and a half in it, I do feel like this foam does start to wear on the legs a little bit. You're not getting so much pushback because there is no plate and it is such a big stack of soft foam. I think it maybe takes a little bit more out of the legs than you get from something like the Endorphin Speed or Deviate Nitro with the plate, or just a shoe with a lower stack and slightly firmer foam, which is kind of giving you a bit more response. So there is that kind of feeling I have with it as well. And I still do have those caveats from the same kind of thing when it comes to all out pace in the shoe. I think you get lost a little bit in this foam and it bottoms out slightly, but it still has been a really quite an impressive all-round shoe for me. I like it a lot more now than I did after my first run, if you've seen the first run video. But yeah, I'm still not entirely sure it's one that I've truly fallen in love with. So yeah, the New Balance Rel V2 is a shoe. I think it's one of the rare cases of a shoe where I would say it probably won't make my rotation, but I still feel quite comfortable recommending it as a shoe that a lot of people I think will really like. I mean, there's obviously been loads of hype out there. Loads of people love this shoe. I don't love it. I really think it's pretty good, and I think I can see why people do really like it. Just having a shoe that's so lightweight, so nimble, and yet still can handle such a wide variety of runs in kind of your daily training and do them all pretty well. It's just a, you know, it's great. And especially that it's coming in at £120, which isn't cheap, but it's not kind of even the kind of 150-ish price of things like the Endorphin Speed and other shoes like that that do have some kind of plate in them. I still feel like I say it bottoms out a little bit at really high paces and over longer runs. And if I was using it as a daily trainer, I think doing kind of a full week of around 100K and just 90 to 100K, and just I feel like it might take a little bit more out of my legs than some of the other shoes out there now. But maybe this might be a problem with me. I feel like a few years ago, this would have been, oh my God, this shoe would have absolutely blown my mind. But now I'm so cosseted at like training in shoes with like nylon plates at least in them all the time, that I can't recognize what a great shoe this is, because I need a plate now. I'm being babied by all these amazing running shoes out there. Maybe they should just ban plates, and then, well, you know, I can go back to adoring a shoe like this, which is a big, it's a kind of shoe that didn't really exist too well before. These kind of super foams have really changed the game, and just because it hasn't got a plate in it doesn't really lessen the fact that this is a very high performance shoe in a very lightweight package despite all that foam. However, the shoes with plates do exist. They haven't been banned, and I do prefer the feel of the Saucony Endorphin Speed or the Fuel Cell TC, which is obviously a lot more expensive, has a similar stack of foam, but does have a plate in there just to give you a bit more stability and a bit more propulsion, you know, to send you on your way when you are squidging deep into these foams at high paces. I do also really like the Puma Deviate Nitro, but that has a massive fatal flaw in that there's not any padding around the heel. It doesn't seem like a heel design that grips your Achilles tightly enough, and I've had lots of problems with it, you know, rubbing and eventually cutting the skin on my Achilles, and so did Kieran, another run tester. So it does kind of put it out of the running for me, but it does have a very nice ride if you don't have those problems with it. And speaking of Puma, one other shoe I would compare it to quickly is the Liberate Nitro, which is very similar to this in many ways. It's really lightweight. It's actually under 200 grams, but it has a reasonable stack of foam. I do think it's something, a shoe that people are using for lots of different kinds of runs. I think it has a similar problem to the New Balance V2, and that I don't think it's amazing to push past kind of an hour, 75 minutes regularly. But the Liberate Nitro has another problem, which is, again, heel rub. It has the same heel design as the Deviate Nitro, and for me, I've had such problems with heel rub with those shoes. Again, anytime I'm running reasonably long in the shoe or using them a couple of days in a row, that I would suggest the New Balance Rebel is a safer pick, purely for the sake of your Achilles, if you have any worries about that. But yeah, the Liberate Nitro has been a shoe I've quite enjoyed using in limited testing so far. But yeah, there's also shoes without plates that I still kind of prefer to this shoe. The Hoka Mach 4 is one of my favorite new shoes of this year. I think it's got a much smoother ride than this. It's a bit more stable. It hasn't got the kind of bounce of this foam, but I've really liked running hard sessions in it, doing long hard runs in it, and it's also pretty lightweight. So yeah, and that's around a similar price. I prefer the Hoka Mach 4 to this shoe. And I also really like the Brooks Hyperion Tempo. I kind of used it a lot last year. I haven't used it so much this year. It is a much firmer shoe than the New Balance Rebel. I will say that. It's really good at fast paces, but I don't think it handles easy stuff as well as this shoe. But that is another option without a plate out there that I know some people do like as a daily trainer, but I think it's just a bit too hard on the legs to keep using it day in, day out, whereas this does have more protection, even if it's not necessarily the best over really long, regular, very long runs. I also really like the fact that the shoe is so lightweight and comfortable, and I think it's the kind of shoe that's, for me, is kind of making dedicated easy day shoes a little bit redundant. I'm not a huge user of just, a huge cushy shoe to have in my rotation just purely for easy runs. I think there's so many good shoes like this now that actually can handle pace as well as those easy runs that it does make me feel that I don't really need one of those high cushion shoes just for easy runs. There's things like this which are 200 grams and yet still soft and cushy and can kind of do it all. So yeah, in summary, it's a shoe that I've not been 100% won over by myself, but I think a lot of runners out there will really like it. I would certainly add it to your list of shoes to consider, especially if you're someone who doesn't want to use a plate in your shoe in training. If you are happy with a plate, then I do think the Endorphin Speed is a better shoe. If you want a plate with the fuel cell foam, the TC I think is a more enjoyable shoe as well for me. But yeah, I don't want to do this down too much. It's not a shoe that's entirely won me over, but it is a very good shoe, a shoe I haven't had a bad run in yet, but I just think there's a few shoes out there that I slightly prefer at the moment. So guys, that is our review of the New Balance FuelSeal Rebel V2. Let us know what you think in the comments. Please like, subscribe, ring the little bell so you get notified when we launch a new video. And yeah, we will see you next time.